Mary was very surprised by this and wondered what the angel meant. This angel said to her, "Don't be afraid. God has been very kind to you. You will become pregnant by the Holy Spirit and give birth to a baby boy, and you will call him Jesus. He will be God's own son, and his kingdom will never end." Mary was very afraid, but she trusted God. "Let it happen as God chooses," she replied to the angel. Gabriel also told Mary that her cousin Elizabeth, who everyone thought was too old to have children, would have a baby, by whom God has chosen to prepare the way for Jesus.
Mary said goodbye to her family and friends, and went to visit her cousin Elizabeth and her husband Zechariah. Elizabeth was very happy to see Mary. She knew that Mary had been chosen by God to be the mother of his son, and an angel already told Zechariah and Elizabeth baby would prepare people to welcome Jesus. He was to be called John. Mary stayed with Elizabeth about 3 months and returned home to Nazareth.
Joseph was worried when he found out Mary was expecting a baby before their marriage had taken place. He wondered if he should put off the wedding altogether. Then an angel appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, "Don't be afraid to have Mary as your wife." The angel explained that Mary had been chosen by God to be the mother of his son and told Joseph that the baby boy would be named Jesus, which means Savior, because he would save people. When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel told him to do and took Mary as his wife.
All this time, the land where Mary and Joseph lived was a part of the Roman Empire. The Roman Emperor August wanted to have a list of all the people in the empire to make sure they paid their taxes. He ordered everyone to return to the town where their families originally came from and entered their names in the register there. Mary and Joseph traveled about 70 miles from Nazareth to Bethlehem because that is where Joseph's family came from. Most people walked, but some lucky people had a donkey to help carry the goods needed for the journey. Joseph and Mary traveled very slowly because Mary's baby was due to be
When they reached Bethlehem, they had problems finding somewhere to stay. So many people had come to register their names in the census, that every house was full and that every bed was taken in all of the guest rooms. The only place to stay that they could find was with the animals.
Then many more angels appeared, lighting up the sky. The shepherds heard them praising God. glory to God in the highest, and peace to everyone on earth. When the angels had gone, the shepherds said to one another, Let's go to Bethlehem to see what has happened. So the shepherds went to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph. The baby Jesus was lying in a manger, as they had been told. When they saw him, they told everyone what the angel had said, and everyone who heard the story were astonished. Then the shepherds returned to their sheep, praising God for sending his son to be their savior.
When Jesus was born, a brand new bright star appeared in the sky. Some wise men in faraway countries saw the star and knew what it meant. They were very clever men and studied the stars, and it had a very old writing that a new star would appear when a great king was born. They set out to find the new king and bring him gifts. The wise men followed the star towards the country of Judah, and when they got to the capital called Jerusalem, they began to ask people, "Where is the child who's been born king of the Jews?" Herod, the king of Judah, heard this and made him very angry to think someone might be taking his place. As King Herod sent his wise men to come to him, he told them to go on following the star until they have found the baby king. He said, "When you have found him, let me know where he is so I can go worship him." But Herod did not tell them that he really had an evil plan in mind to kill the new king.
The wise men followed the star towards Bethlehem, where it said that the king would be born in the old writings. It seemed to stop and shine directly down upon the place where Jesus was. The wise men entered the house where they now live and found Jesus with Mary. They bowed down and worshipped him. The wise men spread the gifts they had brought before Jesus. The gifts were gold, frankincense, and myrrh. The wise men were warned in a dream by God not to go back to Herod, so they returned to their home countries in the east by a different way.
When the wise men had gone,